Now, in this module 4, we'll give you a very brief introduction to networks. So the outline of this module is that we'll first talk about networks, and then we will get on to what are perhaps the most important networks that are IP-based, i.e. internet protocol-based networks. So if you ask the question, what is a network? Now, a network is just simply a collection of computers that can communicate with each other. A computer is connected to a network, typically via a Wi-Fi or Ethernet. Each computer on a network is called a host, and terms like LAN, which is local area network, and WAN, wide area network, are used to describe different network types based on their size and configuration. So a very simple network is just a router with some computers which is connected to it. So in a sense, the simplest network you can think of is actually just the host by itself. So by default, the IP address 127.0.0.1 refers to the host itself. Now, the network that we are really interested in is the internet, and the internet is the world's largest computer network. In fact, it is by far the largest engineered system that humans have ever built. And if you look at the size and the sheer scale of the network, it's almost quite a surprise that it can still offer us all kinds of services fairly reliably. So if you look at this particular picture of the internet, here each line is drawn between two nodes representing two IP addresses. It's really quite a beautiful picture of the internet. Now, the networks that we're interested in are IP networks. So the most common networks are internet protocol-based networks. An IP network is nothing but a communication network that uses the internet protocol to send and receive messages between one or more computers. So technologies such as Ethernet, Wi-Fi, 2G, 3G, 4G are all different kinds of networks at the physical slash link layer, but they all use the IP system, quote unquote, the IP protocol to manage their communication. Now, here's just a simple caricature of an Ethernet type network, and you have an example of a Wi-Fi hotspot. Now, let's get on to IP addresses. Now, every host on a network has a unique IP address that other hosts use to communicate with it. So, an IP address is a 32-bit number for IPv4, typically represented in the format 0 to 255.0 to 255, and so on. So, for example, you have the number 10.34.245.273 for better readability. Now, host could either have a fixed IP or a temporary dynamic IP assigned to it by the network every time it connects to it. Now, a question is, which program on the computer do you want to reach? So, even though our messages and data can reach the computer, how do we know which program to contact on the computer? Now, programs use port numbers as addresses within the same computer. Port numbers vary from 1 to 65,536. Web servers typically run on port 80 for HTTP and port 443 for HTTPS. So the browser always tries to reach port 80 or 443 unless specified otherwise. So, for example, when you go to google.com, that's equivalent to google.com:443, or hindu.com, that's equivalent to thehindu.com:80, and HTTP localhost:8080 is the same as my custom web server listening on port 8080 on my own computer. So, how do these programs really understand each other's messages? Now, web servers and clients agree to communicate in a format called HTTP, which is the Hypertext Transfer Protocol. And HTTP is a format that mandates the following items: a URL, which is the Uniform Resource Locator, headers and method type, and body. So we want to end this brief introduction to networks by making an important statement. And the statement is as follows: that my browser is a program that can connect to some program, the server, on some machine somewhere on the network. So the important question that comes up is the following, and that is, how does this actually happen? And it can happen in one of the following ways. So if computers can discover each other, if computers can message each other in a way that both can understand each other, if a program can discover a specific program on another computer, and if a program can message another program in a way that both can understand each other. So this effectively brings us to the end of this very brief introduction to networks, where we wanted to highlight the importance of IP, i.e. Internet Protocol based networks.